I think Alberta taxpayers gave Rachel Notley a $10,000 social media bump in her failed bid to be re-elected. Today, I'll show you the contract for Notley's self-serving Facebook ad paid for by the government of Alberta, which means you. I received Freedom of Information documents that show Premier Rachel Notley spent nearly $10,000 taxpayer money on Facebook promotions to increase her visibility as some sort of pipeline champion, which we know isn't completely true. It's antithetical to everything we know about the NDP. They're anti-pipeline, anti-energy, anti-resource development. Now, we asked the Premier's office for any records or expense records relating to Facebook and Twitter posts made on or behalf of the Alberta Premier from the beginning of when she became Premier back in 2015 all the way through to November 8th, 2019. So we even encompassed some of Jason Kenney's new time in office. I got back two pages, both relating to former Premier Rachel Notley. God, it feels good to say that. The first contract happens based on the dates we have here between July 1st and August 31st, 2018. And the contract was initially for $20,000. However, we can see on the very next page that roughly 7 months later, the company contracted to run the Facebook promotion refunded over $10,000 of the $20,000 contract as unused. The ads were meant to target English-speaking Canada on Facebook news feeds. And we know this is related to the energy file because it's for the Notley pro-pipeline initiative called Keep Canada Working, which were really just a couple of poorly run pro-energy Twitter and Facebook accounts paid for by Alberta taxpayers. Those accounts, well, they weren't really doing or saying anything that people like Robbie Picard at Oil Sands Strong or Rally for Resources hadn't already been saying 1,000 times louder with thousands of more people listening to them without costing Alberta taxpayers a penny. So based on the fact that Keep Canada Working is involved and the ads were targeting English-speaking Canada and it happened sort of at the end of August, I'm assuming it has to do with this tweet here. Notley's tweet contained a link to a now-deleted Facebook Live event where Notley said she would pull out of the National Climate Plan to protest the Federal Court of Appeals decision to put Trans Mountain Pipeline on hold. We spent $10,000 to promote something and then she deletes it. And the threat was meaningless anyway because Notley was keeping her own climate plan, the job-killing carbon tax on everything. And the Facebook ads were misplaced wastes of money. A lot of the opposition coming to Alberta pipelines has been coming out of French-speaking Canada. So it appears as though Notley wasn't trying to move the needle at all with her Facebook Live idol threats, but instead she was just spending $10,000 to preach to the choir to seem like she was doing something while actually doing nothing at all. For Rebel News, I'm Sheila Gunn Reid. Hey, did you know that Rebel News is going on an Alaskan cruise and you can come too? We leave July 4th. We're back July 11th. You can get all the details and see the ship, which is gorgeous, at rebelnewscruise.com.